This match is one fall with a 20-minute time limit. First from Scotland, weighing 231 pounds, Scott McGee. His opponent will be led to the ring by the Wizard from the jungles of Samoa, weighing 299 pounds, Sika.
Gorilla Monsoon here at ringside in the Boston Garden with my colleague and longtime friend, Lord Alfred Hayes. And take a look at these two awesome creatures.
Oh, gosh.
Talk about Nightmare City. Oh, this is it.
Enough to strike fear in the heart of the most courageous person. Gosh, just look at them.
A look of destruction on the face of Sika.
And there's the Wizard looking for the other Wizard.
Claims to be at 40,000 feet most of the time, and he says that the Grand Wizard is hovering somewhere in that neighborhood.
Yes, and he looks for inspiration, which he says he gets from the Grand Wizard.
Maybe
look at
Seeker.
He's a giant of a man, Seeker. Well over 300 pounds looking at him there.
Young Scotty McGee will have to put it all together here if he wants to get by this big guy. That's a mistake. He's trying everything. Nothing having too much success at the moment.
No.
Look at that power move there.
Caught him in there. Oh, golly. That was a power slam and everything all mixed into one there. Put McGee down, and I don't think McGee's going to get up so easily from that.
That won't do too much good for that previously injured back of young Scotty McGee.
No. Here's a courageous youngster, Scotty McGee, but against this awful, awful prospect of facing this man, Sika, aided by the Wizard, it's a daunting prospect.
Well, he had a back injury that would, I thought, terminate his career, Alfred. He had a crushed transverse process of the fourth or fifth thoracic vertebrae, which, you know, could, you know, that's you talking about Main City.
Your knowledge of anatomy never fails to absolutely astound me.
Well, that was one of my favorite subjects, that in kinesiology. Oh, look out, Scotty, in hard. An elbow.
When he wants to, Sika, he can move fast too. He turns the speed on. Coming around here at this very moment, I can see the Wizard, so I'm
dragging his ponderous 400-pound body in our direction. Wizard, would you like to enlighten us a little bit? I understand that you're trying to reach and get into direct communication with the late Grand Wizard.
Yuma Matsum! The Grand Wizard told me to go down into the sewers beneath the hollow Boston Garden so you could see the other side of the view when the Samoan drop really comes, and it's coming.
Thank you for your time. I don't appreciate you spitting all over my arm, but thank you for your time. Take a hike, big boy.
Whilst you were speaking, Gorilla, the young Scott McGee was waging his war there against Sika, and it was really coming to no avail whatsoever, and Sika has dominated this match from the opening bell.
What did the Wizard say, Alfred?
Whoa! I wasn't quite sure, but I wasn't going to look at him because he looked at me earlier and frightened the living daylights out of me.
I couldn't make heads or tails. I asked him a simple question. He was talking about the bowels underneath the Boston Garden. In the meantime, Scotty is getting his clock cleaned by Sika right in the middle of the ring, and now he manages this might be the best move he made all night. The ring.
Yeah, he hasn't made any other offensive move of any effect against Sika whatsoever. Look at Sika, completely unperturbed. He's oblivious to pain, impervious to punishment. What can you do to a thing like him?
Get him a bath and a haircut.
Oh, look at him.
Oh, he didn't
punish
slam him. He drove him down into the canvas.
Nearly drove him through. Look at the ring there. The slam that he made has knocked the shape out of the ring.
Sika asking for applause from this crowd here is not going to get any.
I don't think so. And that is a blatant chokehold right in front of the referee. And there's nothing he can do except stop that. McGee, I don't know what he's doing. He doesn't seem to have any game plan at all left now. It's all gone. Everything's gone out the window. No offense left. His defense is absolutely down. He is in a hopeless no-win situation.
Sika staring over at the Wizard, who I think gave some kind of sign to put this youngster away. Wow, oh, can't do it with that kind of move. Drop kick out of nowhere.
And actually floored the big man. Put him down.
Ducked underneath a big blow, but oh, leapfrog.
Nice moves by Scotty. Oh, wow! Oh, my word. Oh, you must take your hat off to Seeker there. He absolutely just took that boy up on his shoulders and plunged him back first into the mat.
Sort of devastating, wasn't it?
Wow.
The winner of this match, Seeker.
Seeker with his hand raised in a token of victory just when Scotty thought he had things going his way as he unleashed a nice drop kick.
That was definitely a good drop kick. And here he ducked underneath that clothesline, came across with another leapfrog. But look at this, the way Seeker just took him and immediately, bam!
Scotty went for a high cross body and it cost him. Ooh. The big guy lowered the boom on him right here in the Boston Gardens. Keep your eye on Seeker and the Wizard heading for higher and better things here in the World Wrestling Federation. We'll be back.